Hey Juice TV, my name's Toma.
And my name's Alannah.
Check out this controller we found. Looks a bit ancient. I don't even know if this thing still works.
There's only one way to find out.
Whoa, that was epic! There's so many things to explore on the controller.
Hey, can I have a try?
Sure.
Ew! Sorry about that.
Does that mean...
It's a bit hot in here.
It's rather toasty.
Can we turn on the AC?
Too cold, too cold. Press something else.
Okay.
Ah, this is nice. Are you cool with this?
I'm cool with this.
This thing has powers like I've never seen before.
Can we please press another button? Just like one button.
Pretty please.
I mean, all right. If I could have anyone at my party, it would obviously be my family. My sister knows exactly what I want. My mom makes the best cakes.
If I came to my brother's birthday, I would 100% get him a nice medium rare brisket. Yeah. And a barbecue, because he loves meat.
Yeah, I can vouch for that. For my dream birthday party, I'll be flying first class to Italy. Get in the gondola, eat some spaghetti, mamma mia.
Mamma mia!
If I could invent my own ice cream, it would be a three-course meal. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Hear me out. Hash browns. Bacon and egg muffin, maybe a bit of toast. That's the first layer. Second layer, we're going lunch, salad, and then dinner. Spaghetti bolognese with panini bread. I'm a genius, right? Willy Wonka, watch out.
Hidden talents, well yeah, I can speak a bit of Spanish. Like this, suscríbase a la televisión Juice. That means subscribe to Juice TV. Wink.
What would be my ideal weekend? Oh, if I had a free Saturday, I'd phone up Robert Smith and David Grohl and we'd go for a skate. Ooh, I guess boys do cry.
Well, that's enough about us two. I don't know what happens if you press another button.
Hey guys, I'm Dahlia, and I'm checking out one of the coolest new features at Brisbane EKKA. For the first time in 142 years, the EKKA will host two of the largest pinball arcade competitions in the Southern Hemisphere. There's 50 pinball machines and 20 original arcade games. Before I take on the machines, let's meet the master.
Know a thing or two about pinball machines.
I do, Dahlia. My name's Jimmy Nails and I'm the director of the BPAC arcade and the showcase this weekend.
Wow.
And we're doing 10 days straight of pinball tournaments here
at
the EKKA.
That's a long time.
It is a long time.
So what's the aim of the game? How do you play pinball?
Well, first of all, you put a dollar in the machine, you press the start button for the amount of players that you want, you plunge the ball on the right here, and then you use the flippers to control the ball and get it up into the play field, hit switches, light locks, and try and work your way through the storyline of the machine.
Can you tell me about the competitions you're running here at the EKKA?
Yeah, so we're running tournaments here for 10 days straight. We've got nearly 60 pinball machines here and we're going to have over 200 competitive players come through. And this weekend is the biggest one. I've got the Brisbane Pinball Masters on. We've got the 160 best players in Australia are going to be here, plus about 20 international players. The number 5 player in the world is here. So it's a very big event with some very high quality players.
What's the youngest competitor you've ever seen?
The youngest competitor that I know of is my friend Holly's little boy, who's 3 years old and he stands on a milk crate to play the games.
Wow, if a three-year-old can do it, surely I can do it. Jimmy, can you show me how to play?
I'd love to, Dahlia. Let's head over this way. Now, to get going, first you plunge the ball. And be ready for it to come down. That's it, good shot. Well done. To try and hit the ball at Groot's mouth, and he'll open the mouth and he'll collect three balls. Now, see, you've got the red shots flashing. So see if you can hit any of those. There you go, you got Groot once. The general rule with pinball, if something's flashing, it means you're supposed to hit it. Dahlia, that was your first time playing pinball. What did you think?
Fun, but very hard.
It's a hard game when you're first starting out. Play as much as you can. Play one whenever you see it and be patient. It's a hard game to learn, but when you do it, it's very rewarding. When you can get to the wizard modes, it's a very exciting thing to achieve.
Thanks so much for your help, Jimmy, and one day I'll be competing with pros too.
My pleasure, Dahlia. Good luck with the practice and hopefully we'll see you competing soon.
I'm Dahlia and this is Jimmy. Bye!
Hey, I didn't mean to make you leave, but those pinball machines were epic.
Wow, Amy, we've found some cheat codes. Let's try them.
Up, down, left, right, hold X, PlayStation.
Ah, nice, disco mode, that's cool. Let's try another one. Down, up, PlayStation Square. Ah, no, that's just less of a vibe. Maybe let's try one last cheat code. Triangle, 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 circle. I mean, I guess this is a vibe. I don't even know what this is anymore. Well, I gotta figure out how to reset this. Let's see what games were like before cheat codes.
Do your parents say things like, back in my day? Or when I was a kid? And talk about olden stuff?
Ooh.
Yeah, mine too. Let's look at some old video games and see if they're actually any good. My name's William and welcome to Retro Review. Let's start with one of the oldest video games from 1972, Pong. It's a very straightforward video game that is pretending to be ping pong, where the player controls a bar and you have to stop the dot crossing your side. Time for our retro review. First, let's choose by difficulty. Let's go easy. Wow, controlling this bar's a little bit confusing. Now I'm getting the hang of it. Ooh, I'm getting close to winning. You beauty. I think that game was pretty fun and easy, but a lot of it was pretty hard. Especially to try and keep it in the lines when it was just bouncing everywhere. I'll probably give it like a 7 out of 10. On to the next review. Next up, we have Space Invaders, made in 1978. Players control a small spaceship and must shoot down aliens as they slowly come down to Earth. It was the most successful video game of its time and was a big influence for the next generation of video game designers. Let's stop talking about it and let's play it. Whoa, that's a lot of aliens. Oh, sweet, I can move my spaceship around. They're no match for my laser beam. Take that and that. Oh no, they're getting close. Oh, there's two left. Got one. Oh no. I think it was pretty hard, but I still gave it a crack and it was a good shot. I reckon I'll probably give it a good 9 out of 10. Lastly, we have one of the most famous video games, Pac-Man. In 1980, this cute little fella made his way to gaming arcades. It was the first game ever to use power-ups, which at the time was groundbreaking. Running around the mazes, collecting pellets, and eating ghosts, this game totally holds up. Let's play. So I used this stick to control Pac-Man. pinball ghost, piece of cake. If I can escape them. Oh, wow. That turned the ghost blue.
Yum, yum, yum.
Boy, it's a bit tricky trying to navigate the maze. I really like this game, and it was pretty hard, especially because the ghosts were the eaters. Pac-Man was only the eater.
Ooh.
And I give it a pretty straight 7 out of 10. Well, parents, maybe some of the games back in your day were fun. That was my retro review. My name's William. See you later.
Wow, those games look like a lot of fun.
While you were gone, we were able to undo all the cheat codes.
With great power comes great responsibility. Huh, just kidding. I can just use it to get what I want.
Oh, yeah.
Potato, potato.
Have you met Harry? He's going to review one of the games I want to play. Let's watch.
Hi, my name is Harry, and welcome to Harry's Gaming Minute. Starting now. Today we're going to be talking about a game that's very special to me and that's been a big part of my hospital journey, Stardew Valley. Stardew Valley is the first game developed by aspiring developer Eric Barone, more prominently known as Concerned. It started development in 2011 and released on the 26th of February 2017. Stardew Valley is a farming cross life simulator that takes heavy inspiration from the hit series Harvest Moon, but manages to do its own thing 10 times over. The thing about Stardew Valley is it doesn't really have an end. You can keep playing your farm infinitely and it's still fun.
Ooh.
But there are still some goals to complete, one of which is completing the community center by using the game's mechanics, like farming and fishing, to fill out rooms to make it a great new place. Speaking of mechanics, the main ways of farming without growing food are getting animals, foraging, fishing, mining. Like I said before, Stardew Valley is a life simulator. You can get a pet, make friends with the locals, and even attend town events. It's truly amazing. Stardew Valley is one of the most relaxing games of all time, and as someone who spent a long time isolated in a hospital bed, Stardew Valley was like a second life to me, something that I could look forward to. If this game piques your interest, on the screen now are a few safe reviews that have more time to better explain the game. I give Stardew Valley 10 turnips out of 10.
Oh man, I was having so much fun with this thing. I gotta charge this controller so I can do all my evil bidding and take over the world. Like, what?
I'm gonna miss the disco. It's not the same.
Thanks for watching Juice TV. See you next time.